Also really getting out in transition and scoring some hoops in the fast break tonight.
He thought he had that one clean, but the refs
dialed in from long range. I like it.
Ennis is checked in.
Let's see what you got, son.
12 seconds left in the third quarter. Outside Jackson. Knocked away. Got it off in time. And it's good. But hold on. The officials may want to look at that one on the replay monitor. And not so fast. The officials are going to check that shot again and make sure they got it right before we go to the fourth.
And to me, it looks pretty clear on the instant replay, guys. The ball was out of his hands in time. I mean, they need to get this.
In a moment now to check out our State Farm assist of the game, and what a pass it was by a talented point guard.
Well, this is what he does. This is the kind of plays he's known for, Kevin.
Miami leading by 15. Tiny, he's in at point guard. On the perimeter, Wade and Dang. Chris Bosh is out there with Whiteside. That's the group on the floor for Miami. Here's Kidd Gilchrist. Here's Hixon. And it's Miami with the rebound. Wade passes to Tiny. From deep three-point range, Vonleh with the rebound. Hornets trail by 15. Here is Tiny. Kidd Gilchrist comes with the double team. Dang kicks to Wade. Whiteside dishes to Wade. Five to shoot. Fires the three. They grab their own miss. Bosh can't hit. For Charlotte, they've gone 0-3 to start the fourth quarter. Thomas goes in. Outside Kidd Gilchrist. No good. Bosh with some nice D. The Heat leading by 15. Here's Tiny. Trains the three-pointer. Tiny's got the fourth quarter going with the first basket of the period here for the Heat. Here is Stevenson. They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Sure could, Kev. I mean, too many empty trips. They need some points.
Well-contested shot there.
And that's the key defensively. You've got to make them work for it. Challenge every shot.
Tiny. And again, Miami with the triple. Tiny.
You know, the more these three-pointers continue to drop, the more you can sense the frustration coming from this defense.
No question. No matter what they've thrown at them, they've not been able to take that shot away.
Outside Thomas. Hixon sets the screen for Thomas. Lock at six. And the Hornets miss again. Miami's gone 2-5 on three-point shots since the end of the third quarter. And he gets it to go. And it's 37 points for Tiny.
This looks like a pregame shoot-around with all the threes they're allowing.
Yeah, I don't know, Clark. I think there might be even more defense in warm-ups. I mean, this is kind of embarrassing.
Josh McRoberts has checked in for Miami. Jefferson's checked in for Charlotte. Over to Doris Burke for an update.
Well, Kevin, Steve Clifford was just going over the game plan with his team. He went over the offensive plan and that it hinges on running things through Jefferson. Coach has a lot of faith in him offensively and let his players know it, insisting that he be at the forefront of what they do at that end of the court from here on out. Likely the final major changes to their game plan as they try to make a late comeback here in the fourth. Kevin, back to you.
Thanks again, Doris. Thomas up top. Stevenson outside. That one falls, coming off of Thomas's feed.
How about the response? Retaliation. Impressive, huh, guys?
I'll say exactly that as well. Nice job to recover those 3 points right away.
Three-pointer. Vonleh with the rebound. Vonleh's got his seventh rebound here tonight. Stevenson with it. Wade picks him up. Stevenson kicks to Thomas. Now the feed to Jefferson. And Thomas, here we go, finds the bottom of the bucket from 13 feet out.
Easy little jump shot for him right there, guys.
Miami leading by 22.
Inside 2 minutes.
Fires the three. No good from Tiny. 1:56 left to play in the final quarter. Thomas passes to Stevenson. Shot clock at 6.
That's a jump ball.
And it's the Hornets with the ball. Just 5 to shoot. Thomas gets a wide open look. And another 3 for Charlotte.
Something's starting to click for this team, guys. You can feel it. The three-pointers are dropping. Their offense is flowing.
They've had a great second half from long range.
That's a bold move, trying to respond to that 3, but he couldn't convert. And so here we go, just rolling along to the finish line in what has been a very confident-looking performance for the Heat.
It was like watching a 3-point shooting contest tonight here, Clark.
I call them warm-up jump shots. I mean, 3 after 3, it paid off for them in the end.
And so with this, they'll end up with their second win on the year.
And guys, when you're cracking heads against somebody 4 times over the course of a season, boy, it's a great feeling to snatch that first game. Good adjustments tonight against the Hornets.
And what a huge standout performance it was for Tiny. Now, there wasn't much they could do to slow him down as he was converting every opportunity he got.
41 seconds left in the fourth quarter. And it's the Hornets ball. A 12-0 run right now and counting. Thomas kicks to Stevenson. Jefferson has a wide open look. That ball. Nice feed that time from Stevenson.
Well, their offense has kicked into gear, but seems to have arrived a little bit too late.
And as a coach, that can really be frustrating. I mean, your guys were stumbling along for most of the game, and now, when it's basically over, they finally decide to come alive.
Here's Tiny. From deep. Bucket's good. And so Miami takes this one by a big margin. You know, Clark. Every team has a bad night, and these guys might want to watch the tape of this game the next time they have a bad night to remind themselves how dominant they can be.
Well, this is one of those dreamlike games for a coach.
And that'll do it for Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr, and Doris Burke. This is Kevin Harlan. Thanks for watching this presentation of the NBA on 2K Sports. And now we present the Jordan Player of the Game, Tiny.
crib, ma.
Drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot.
When the pigs try to get at you,
park it like it's hot.
It's game time here in Miami as the crowds at the American Airlines Arena look to cheer on the hometown Heat. For the Miami Heat, they are coming off a good outing against the Charlotte Hornets. And there wasn't much question as to... game was going to turn out. They absolutely put the hammer down on them.
Well, Kevin, they constructed a perfect offensive game plan going into that game, and it was quickly apparent how powerless the defense was to stop it.
Powerless is a good way to put it, Steve. We're unlikely to see that many uncontested baskets again anytime soon.
All right, let's set the floor, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. So for Toronto right now, DeRozan and Ross, they're the 2 and 3. Patterson is the 4 with Valanciunas in the middle. And it's Paul in at the 1 spot. No good from Tiny. Toronto with the ball. They're coming into this game off that recent loss to Atlanta.
And a loss like that, guys, you've just got to flush it down the toilet and put it behind you.
Yeah, you do, Steve, but it's much easier said than done. I mean, it's hard not to dwell on the type of poor performance it was for them.
DeRozan's shot is good. DeRozan's got his first points of the game.
The screenplay worked ideally there, and I'm not talking about the screenplay you see in a movie theater. Gave him more than enough room to get that shot off.
Heads up, aggressive play right there. He saw the smaller man on him, took it straight to the basket.
Here's Paul. After the made shot from Tiny, no good from Valanciunas. They set the pick. And it's Dang in the corner. Back to Wade. Wade, left side. There's the pass to Tiny. The shot's good on the assist by Wade. Tiny's got 5 points so far.
A good open look, and he splashes home the 3.
And it's Paul penetrating. He sinks the 11-footer.
How about that? Gets it off right in the face of the big fella. Quick release.
And operating on the perimeter like that negates some of the height disadvantage, too.
Here's Tiny against Charlotte. He was really on his game. Fires from deep, and the Heat, another 3.
Tiny